Tropical Cyclone Jasper, now re-intensified to a Category 2 system, is expected to cross the Queensland coast within the next 24 hours. Our current tropical cyclone warning extends from Cape Flattery to Lucinda and inland to Chilligo. In these areas, we've already seen some gusty winds and rainfall starting to develop, but through the rest of this afternoon and evening, we're going to see widespread heavy rainfall and sustained gale force winds with damaging wind gusts developing, particularly through the overnight period as Jasper nears the coast. So far today, Tropical Cyclone Jasper has moved towards the Queensland coast and re-intensified into a Category 2 system. It's currently sitting around 230 kilometres to the northeast of Cairns. Through the next 12 to 18 hours, we're going to see the system continuing to move towards the coast. At this point, we are expecting to see a coastal crossing around the Woodjil Woodjil Cape Tribulation area around lunchtime tomorrow or possibly the early afternoon. The details of the timing and location of the coastal crossing may change a little bit over the next 12 to 18 hours. So if you live anywhere within our watch or warning areas, it is imperative you keep up to date, not only with our latest forecasts and warnings, but also with the advice from your local emergency services. This is because as Jasper nears the coast, we are going to see the most intense and most dangerous weather starting to develop. This includes locally intense rainfall between Cape Flattery and Port Douglas, with 6-hourly rainfall totals in excess of 300 millimetres, potentially leading to life-threatening flash flooding that will be starting to develop through early tomorrow morning. Similarly, we're going to see storm tides on the high tides along this same stretch of coast, with the risk of coastal inundation. We're also expecting to see destructive winds developing through the early hours of tomorrow morning, most likely between Woodjil Woodjil and Innisfail, and this is going to be particularly intense close to the core of the system. We can really clearly see it in our forecast wind gusts here. Anything in the black, grey and white is indicating destructive wind gusts, 120, 130, even 140 kilometres an hour. But you can see much broader areas of those coastal parts pushing into the damaging wind gust zone. And that is why our tropical cyclone warning area covers a much larger area of the coast. Now, after it crosses the coast, Jasper is going to start to weaken, first to a Category 1 system, then to a tropical low, with winds easing back accordingly. It'll still be gusty across southern parts of Cape York, but we're going to see an easing in those destructive winds and that locally intense rainfall through Thursday going into Friday. This system continues to evolve as it nears the coast, with the most dangerous weather expected to develop through tomorrow morning. It's essential to stay up to date via the Bureau's website and weather app, and follow all advice from your local emergency services. We'll catch you in the next update.